Wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings He bears to those who trust in His ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dearly beloved brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the feast of the Transfiguration of the Lord. As we enter this holy presence, let us all the more recognize and embrace the voice of the Lord, challenging us and encouraging us to listen to His beloved Son. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us ask the Lord for pardon and for forgiveness. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you,
we bless you,
we adore you,
we glorify you,
we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son confirmed the mysteries of faith by the witness of the fathers, and wonderfully prefigured our full adoption to sonship. Grant, we pray, to your servants, that listening to the voice of your beloved Son, we may merit to become co-heirs with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But we had been eyewitnesses of His majesty. For He received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique declaration came to Him from the majestic glory. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess the prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The Lord is King, let the earth rejoice, let the many islands be glad. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, and all the peoples see his glory.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalted far above all gods.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. Please stand. Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice, This is my beloved Son. Listen to him. Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. We celebrate today the Feast of the Transfiguration of the Lord every 6th of August. And it is at least an automatic imagination or picture that whenever the word transfiguration of the Lord will be told of us, it is an automatic picture that we see Jesus in dazzling white with Moses and Elijah on his side. At syempre, hindi naman po natin ito maipagkakatakwil dahil ayun naman talaga ang nangyari. But you know, more than the event that happened, hopefully, may we not forget the words that came out from that voice from the clouds that spoke, "This is my beloved son, listen to him." We might ask, why those kinds of words? Why end by saying, "Listen to him"? And I'd like you to remember what happened. When Jesus was transfigured before Peter, James, and John, Elijah and Moses stood beside the Lord, conversing with him. The three apostles, more than being amazed at what they've been looking at, became frightened. At bakit po sila natakot? Maybe the vision came to them as an extraordinary one. The vision may be something new for their eyes. They may have heard their conversations that made them fearful. Other commentators were telling that these three were talking about the death that Jesus would face, the exodus of Jesus from death to the experience of the resurrection. At marahil, baka madami pa silang dahilan bakit sila natakot. Pero alam niyo po, bilang minamahal na ama kay Jesus, hindi naman hahayaan ng minamahal na ama na ito na hayaang magmukmok at matakot ang mga minamahal na alagad ng kanyang anak. His way of telling these disciples, "Listen to him," may not only sound as a form of command. Listen to him. If you need anything, listen to Christ. But more than enough, the Lord was as if telling to them, takot kayo sa narinig ninyo at nakita ninyo? Then listen to him. Hirap kayo sa narinig ninyo at marahil sa haharapin ninyong paghihirap sa Jerusalem? Listen to him. Challenge kayo sa gagawin ninyong buhay? Makinig kayo kay Jesus. More than a command, it was a voice of consolation. My dear brothers and sisters, in the event of some fear before the Lord, when challenges of new life, of new opportunities, and maybe with the challenges we face every day, when it seems to be hard and tiring to face the real world, when it is difficult to live our lives today, hear as well that voice from the clouds telling you, "Here is my beloved son. Listen to him." Baka po tayo ay nahihirapan na, tayo ay naguguluhan na, tayo ay nasasaktan na dahil hindi na tayo nakikinig kay Jesus. Baka kaya naliligaw ng landas ang madami sa atin, hindi na tayo nagbabago, hindi na tayo natututo dahil hindi na tayo nakikinig kay Jesus, o baka ayaw na nating pakinggan ang Diyos. Maybe there's chaos. Maybe there's doubt everywhere. We turn to ourselves and only listen to ourselves and no longer listen to what God can teach us about. When we listen to the Lord, He shall speak as a brother ready to help us. He shall speak as a beloved partner, as He is a beloved son to His Father. Makinig tayo at wala pong mawawala sa pakikinig kay Jesus. Makinig upang magkaroon ng buhay. Pakinggan po natin si Jesus para sumulong sa buhay na ito ng walang takot at magpatuloy sa buhay na ito ng may lakas ng loob.
Please stand.
In the Transfiguration, the Father revealed the glory of His Son. We do not see His glory now, but as we wait for the kingdom, we pray in His name to the Father. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the glory of Christ may shine through the church as we faithfully listen to Him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the beloved Son may lead the nations into the paths of peace and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may grow in grace, that others may see the light of Jesus in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people who suffer may see their future in the transfigured Redeemer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may be transfigured in the likeness of Christ's glorious body. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions, for all the intentions offered in this Mass, and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, it is wonderful for us to be here. Receive the prayers of this community assembled to hear your words and to offer the sacrifice of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctify, O Lord, we pray, these offerings here made to celebrate the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son, and by his radiant splendor, cleanse us from the stains of sin. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he revealed his glory in the presence of chosen witnesses, and filled with the greatest splendor that bodily form which he shares with all humanity, that the scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, and that he might show how in the body of the whole church is to be fulfilled what so wonderfully shone forth first in its head. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, that we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all the distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Basan inati
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the heavenly nourishment we have received, O Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you willed to make manifest in his glorious transfiguration, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before imparting the final blessing, I would like to thank the presence of Father Aldwin Herolao. He is my classmate in the seminary and as well my ordination batchmate last December 3 of 2022. We were ordained here at the Manila Cathedral and he's together with some friends from Fujairah, an emirate of UAE for a short visit here at the Manila Cathedral. Nag-serve po si Father Aldwin sa community na yon last year, December activities and Christmas activities. Kaya maraming salamat po for visiting us and for celebrating the Mass with us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you forever and ever.
Amen.
May He let His face shine upon you and be gracious to you forever and ever.
Amen.
May He look upon you with kindness and grant you His peace forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Amen.